the way from the metal to the folk?
We never think about styles when we try to make a song or to compose an album. We just follow our instincts, our thoughts, our feelings. So. We want our listeners to understand the Romanian folklore and folklore elements, generally speaking. So we are focusing on that, on the feeling, on the atmosphere, on our music. Project is a Romanian musical personal project. We are focusing on Romanian folklore. We really like the old traditional ways, and we want to keep alive these traditions. That's why we made our last album called Dor. It is composed of two pieces, one focusing on true authentic Romanian songs, parting ways with the mainstream folklore, and then the other part is a personal interpretation of our own, focusing on some folklore elements that we make our own.
Byłoby powiedzieć, że jesteśmy na koncercie black metalowym, ale tak nie do końca to tak wygląda, ponieważ wy nie gracie black metalu.
Nie, zdecydowanie. Nasza muzyka nawiązuje dużo, dużo większym stopniu do death metalu niż do black metalu, ale bazuje przede wszystkim na zaaranżowaniu elementów folkowych na muzykę metalową. Projekt zaczął się 4 lata temu, ale zaczynaliśmy bardziej od grania power metalu. Skład zmieniał się w czasie bardzo, bardzo, że tak powiem, dynamicznie. I tak naprawdę dopiero od może pół roku funkcjonujemy jako zgrany już ostateczny skład zespołu się ustabilizował i. Na polskiej scenie metalowej nie mamy zbyt wiele kapel nawiązujących do folkloru. Do tej pory graliśmy bardziej przed zespołami zagranicznymi. Graliśmy przed zespołami z Norwegii, z Estonii, z Łotwy. Dzisiaj graliśmy przed zespołem z Rumunii.
Widać, że jest coraz większe zainteresowanie tak naprawdę i jest coraz większa grupa ludzi w Polsce, która się interesuje tego typu muzyką, a tak naprawdę w Polsce jest mało profesjonalnych kapel, które by się zajmowały taką muzyką na poważnie.
Mało
tak
tego,
na dobrą sprawę.
Co ciekawe jest, do tej pory graliśmy głównie przed zespołami black metalowymi, chociaż gramy death metal bardziej niż black, także to jest dość ciekawe.
Na koniec chcieliśmy zareklamować naszą ostatnio wydaną epkę i zaprosić na nasz profil na Facebooku oraz do posłuchania na YouTube.
Na epce znajdziemy 3 utwory plus intro, zrealizowane naszym własnym nakładem. zmiksowane przez profesjonalnego realizatora Daniela Szymonowicza. Polecamy, utwory są dostępne w sieci do posłuchania za darmo.
Negura Bunget, Transylvanian black metal. When people think about Transylvania, they usually think about Count Dracula and things like that. But I think that that the mythology that you that the band is based on is deeper than Count Dracula.
Yes, of course, there are some stereotypes that everybody knows, but there is a lot more on all the stuff like history and spirituality and mythology that most of the people know about. And we enjoy exploring the most unknown parts, try to discover things on our own, and that's always been a fascination for us.
Thracic and Romanian mythology. Can you tell us something about this? Because I think it might be interesting for people in Poland.
Yeah, the Thracs, there were a large tribe that lived throughout the Balkan Peninsula, and on our lands there were a tribe of the Thracs that was called the Dacs.
Yes.
And the Romanian people are said to be like the result of the Roman Empire. They conquered Dacia in 100 BC, and the mixture between the Romans and the local people, along with some other tribes that come along, is the Romanians. So yeah, we enjoy exploring some elements that start even with those times, and some are still present in different ways in the local folklore, the different spiritual elements, and we enjoy going back to time as much as possible. So yes, this is something that we've been interested in since the very beginning. It sounds like a fairy tale, but if you listen there, you find that there is some actual fact that stands behind it. So I will talk about more about our current plans. We are working on, we call it a Transylvanian trilogy. It's three albums, and all albums will also have a visual side. It'll be like almost like a movie. So the first part that should be released next year will be about the nature part, so we will talk about different actual places that have like a strange aura, myth or legend. The name is strange. The second part will focus on the traditions, like what is still carried maybe in a different ways even today, what was over there. And finally, the third part will be about the spiritual elements, like the things that somehow are immortal.
result that black metal in all countries, when people play black metal, is based on, because black metal is very much focused on the tradition and mythology of its own country.
I think some part of black metal, yeah, for us, that it was always important, like the concept behind the music, because in the end the music is just a reflection of that. And I think black metal is one of the very few musical genres where this concept from behind the music is maybe sometimes even more important than the music itself. Because in other genres the lyrics and the content they talk about is less important than the music. But for black metal that is quite different, and we have always enjoyed this. I think there are a lot of Romanian researchers and writers that write about these things, but somehow the most deep things are not widely available and acknowledged. I mean, only the Dracula books and stuff like that get more attention.
Anyway, Dracula was wrote by an Englishman.
yeah, of course, but they now do like a lot of documentaries on Discovery, see what is true and what is not true about Dracula. They come and see a lot of castles in Romania and stuff like that. And that's somehow interesting, but I think it's somehow natural. It's not possible to get like broad attention with something that is very maybe hard to understand. You have to read a lot, have a context for everything, so that is takes a while and takes interest. But I think some start with the more common things and then maybe explore further and see what is really behind everything.
During his career, Negura Bunget came under many personal changes. I think that now you are the only one original member of the band. How do you think? Does it have any influence on the music of the band? Is it good for the band that it broadens the specter of the music? How would you estimate it?
Well, I think there are some positive elements and maybe some not so good ones, because I understand it's not very positive to have a lot of changes. But on the other hand, we also had a very strong activity. I mean, we play like lots of gigs, tours, releases, and that sometimes is too much for people. So we could have maybe taken easy and keep it more so that everybody can do it, but I always try to push it and get to the limit. So yeah, this is the result of that. We'll be right back.
could you tell us a story of the Thracic Romanian mythology, some short story?
Yes, possible. Yes, of course, I could tell you. But on the Romanian folklore, there are all kinds of similar kind of creatures called strigoi or moroni, and somehow people believe that when someone dies in a certain strange circumstance, their soul might not be released to go to the other world and still haunts around this and maybe tries to harm the living people. And then they do some kind of ceremonies, which some are even carried today in some parts of Romania, like they dig up the body and put a nail through the heart, or take a horn. Yeah, that's. But there are all kinds of ceremonies. Are present in different countries and in different ways. So, for example, I will go back to the Dacians times. The Dacians have a high deity or something that was called Zamolxe, and they believe that if they die in the battle, they will just go and stand beside him. And that's why they were like very fierce and had no fear to die. And after the around the times of the when the Roman attacked Dacia, they discovered recently also a grave near Hunedoara, when there was a lot of sacrificial rituals of like little children that they sacrificed just so that maybe the god will be along them and they will defeat the Romans. But also they believed that if they sacrifice in honor to the god, they will just be with the god, their god, so it was not like a sacrifice in vain.
Thank you very much.